Welcome everyone. In the previous two videos, we were discussing the bipolar junction transistor and heterojunction transistor as examples for microwave transistors. Now we are going to discuss the other type of microwave transistors, which is the field effect transistors. And the field effect transistors in microwave, we have three main types of field effect transistor. The first type is the metal semiconductor field effect transistor. The second type is metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. And the third type is high electron mobility transistor. The construction of the field effect transistor is that we have a channel. We have a channel. And this channel is usually N, because as we said, the mobility of the electrons is much higher than the mobility of the holes. So we usually prefer that the major carriers in the microwave transistor to be electrons. So we have a channel of N type, and this channel of N type has two electrodes. One electrode for the source and the other electrode for the drain. And to avoid any Schottky effect between the conductor of the electrode and the semiconductor material, we are going to transfer it from N to N plus below the electrodes for the source and the drain. The main difference between the metal semiconductor field effect transistor and metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor is that in metal semiconductor field effect transistor, the gate is printed directly on the channel or the semiconductor of the channel. So the conductor of the gate with the semiconductor of the channel will introduce Schottky diode here. And such a Schottky diode is usually biased in reverse bias to avoid any current going from the gate to the drain or to the source. The other configuration is the metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. In this case, the gate and the channel are separated by insulating silicon dioxide layer. And this configuration is mainly suitable for silicon field effect transistor. So here the substrate or the channel, and here we have insulating oxide layer and the gate. So the effect here is due to the electric field going from the gate to the channel. But here we have a junction Schottky diode between the gate and the channel. So this is the main difference between the metal semiconductor field effect transistor and metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. Actually, this configuration is more suitable for higher power. Is more suitable for digital applications, for digital circuits. But on the other hand, this configuration will have larger capacitance, and this larger capacitance will reduce the cutoff frequency. So, and it will also require a more complicated fabrication process due to the silicon dioxide layer here. The third type is the high electromobility transistor. Effectively, the idea of the high electromobility transistor is completely different from traditional field effect transistor. Its construction is basically like the metal semiconductor field effect transistor. We have here N plus N plus on the source and the drain, and we have N channel here. and we have the gate connected directly to the channel. So once again, the relation between the gate and the channel is a Schottky diode, and it should be biased in a reverse biasing. The main idea of the high electromobility is using wide band gap material of any type connected to narrow band gap material which is intrinsic. So this connection will introduce a potential well between the N gallium aluminium arsenide and the undoped gallium arsenide. This potential will trap some electrons here at the interface between the wide band gallium aluminium arsenide and the narrow band gallium arsenide. This trapped electron sheet or electron gas, as we will see, will have higher mobility, and we will see why it will have higher mobility. Generally speaking, if we increase the mobility of the carriers in the transistor, means that we increase the speed of the carriers. If we increase the speed of the carriers, we can use it for higher frequency. So this is very simple relation. If I increase the mobility, I can increase the operating frequency. I'm going to discuss how such structure increase the mobility of the electron, but in the following video we are going to discuss in details why this structure increase the mobility. But at least this two-dimensional electron gas has larger mobility, and that's why we are calling this transistor high electron mobility transistor. And as I said, the basic idea of high electromobility transistor is a heterojunction between the wide band gallium aluminium arsenide with the narrow band gallium arsenide, and this doped gallium aluminium arsenide and this undoped gallium arsenide. Okay, so I'm going to leave you interested now in how is this mechanism is going until the next video. But we are going to complete our discussion about general field effect transistor for microwave engineering. So the field effect transistor, we say that in contrast to bipolar junction transistor, field effect transistor are monopolar. Monopolar, it means that we have single carriers from the source to the drain. In the bipolar junction transistor, we have majority of electrons at the emitter, then we have minority of electrons at the base, then we have majority of electrons at the collector. So it is not monopolar. It does not the same type of carrier at all pieces of the transistor. But in the field of the transistor, along all the channel, we have just one carrier. So the field effect transistor are monopolar with only one carrier type, holes or electrons, depending on B type or N type. Usually we use N type. Providing current flow through the device. So in a channel, field effect transistor employs electrons while B channel devices use holes. On the other hand, bipolar junction transistor is a current control device. So by controlling the current of the base, we can control the current at the collector. For the case of the field effect transistor is a voltage controlled device. If we control the voltage at the gate, we can control the current at the drain or the source and the drain. So the bipolar junction transistor is a current control device. However, field effect transistor is a voltage control device having source to drain characteristic that is similar to the voltage dependent variable resistor. So by controlling the voltage at the gate, we can control the drain source current. Types of field effect transistors, as I said, we have three main types. The metal semiconductor field effect transistor, And usually in metal semiconductor field effect transistor, we are using gallium arsenide as semiconductor. So gallium arsenide MESFET are among the most commonly used transistor for microwave and millimeter wave applications, being useful at frequencies up to 60 GHz and more. On the other hand, at higher operating frequency, we can use gallium arsenide high electromobility transistors. Gallium arsenide MESFET and HEMT are especially useful for no-noise amplifiers, since these transistors have low noise figures than any other type of devices. Recently, developed gallium nitride high electromobility transistors are very useful for high power RF and microwave amplifiers. Effectively, the advantage of gallium nitride high electromobility transistor is that they can be used for high frequency and high power simultaneously. Gallium arsenide is useful for high frequency, but it is not useful for high power. On the other hand, complementary metal oxide silicon field effect transistor is increasingly being used for RF integrated circuits, because effectively the technology of CMOS transistor is a common technology, so offering high level of integration at low cost and low power requirements for commercial wireless applications. So this is briefly what are the main types of field effect transistor and what is the difference between of them. For biasing field effect transistor, we need a biasing voltage at the gate, and usually if we are using something like MESFET or HEMT, the gate should be biased with negative voltage, such that the Schottky diode between the gate and the channel is reverse biased to avoid any current going from the biasing or from the gate to the source or the drain. On the other hand, the drain voltage or the drain is connected. The drain is connected directly to VDD. Either the gate or the drain are connected to choke coil. Such choke coils are useful to prevent the RF signal going from the bus to the transistor to the biasing method. So the bus here is going through the transistor only. For a common source configuration, the input it would be the gate through a bypass capacitor, and the output it would be the drain through a bypass capacitor. As we have done for the case of bipolar junction transistor, we should use a biasing point, and this biasing point is determined by the value of the drain source voltage and the drain source current for a specific gate source voltage. So for different values of VGS, we can plot the characteristics of the drain source current versus the drain source voltage. This is the characteristic curve or the biasing curves of the field effect transistor. The small signal equivalent circuit for a microwave field effect transistor in a common source configuration is similar to the bi network for the bipolar junction transistor, but in this case the gate will have internal resistance connected to the gate source capacitance CGS. Usually the internal resistance is very small value, but the dominant it would be the gate source capacitance, and the voltage at the gate to the source is transferred to the drain through a transconductance GM. So there is a current source here, GM multiplied by the voltage at the capacitor VC, and we have in parallel the drain source resistance and the drain source capacitance, and the drain is connected to the gate through a drain gate capacitance CGD, Usually the value of CGD is very small, so we can neglect CGD. So in this case, the device is unilateral, such that the signal is going from the gate to the drain, but the signal cannot go from the drain to the gate. If we are going to compare the different types of microwave transistors, including bipolar junction transistors and Field Effect transistors, for bipolar junction transistor, the semiconductor it could be directly silicon. For heterojunction bipolar transistor, the semiconductor is a combination between silicon and germanium. For complementary metal oxide silicon, metal oxide field effect transistor, CMOS, the material is basically silicon. For the misfit and HEMT, we have gallium arsenide, and also for the HEMT, we can use gallium nitride. As operating frequency range, the bipolar junction transistor can be used up to 10 GHz. The heterojunction bipolar transistor can be used up to 30 GHz or even more, sometimes up to 60 GHz. For complementary metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor, it can be used up to 20 GHz. For the gallium arsenide MOSFET, it can be used up to 60 GHz. For gallium arsenide high electron mobility transistor, it can be used up to 100 GHz. Actually, this number is not correct because nowadays, for gallium nitride high electron mobility transistor, it can be used for more than 100 GHz. And the main advantage of gallium nitride, as I said, can be used for high power and high frequency. So, effectively, this number in the textbook of microwave engineering by Bozar, from the edition about 2005, for example. So, nowadays, in 2020, this number is nearly 100 GHz. The typical gain for bipolar junction transistor in it is around 10 to 15 dB. For heterojunction bipolar transistor is also around 10 to 15 dB. For complementary MOSFET, it is from 10 to 20 dB. For the MOSFET, it is around 5 to 20 dB. For the gallium arsenide HEM, it is from 10 to 20. And for gallium nitride, it is 10 to 15. From the point of view of the noise figure, the bipolar junction transistor has the worst case. It is very high noisy. It is around 2 dB. For heterojunction bipolar transistor, it is around 0.6 dB. For CMOS, it is around 1 dB. For gallium arsenide MOSFET, it is around 1 dB. For gallium arsenide high electromobility transistor, it is around 0.5 dB. And for gallium nitride high electromobility transistor, it is around 1.6 dB. So, if you are planning to design a low noise amplifier, the best amplifier or the best transistor, it would be the gallium arsenide high electromobility transistor. And the worst amplifier is a bipolar junction transistor. Okay. This at frequency 2 GHz, 4 and so on. So, the noise figure measured at this frequency. From the point of view of power capacity, the bipolar junction transistor, it is high power capacity. Also, the high electromobility transistor gallium nitride is high power capacity. So, both bipolar junction transistor and gallium nitride are characterized by high power capacity. But gallium nitride, high power capacity at high frequency. A bipolar junction transistor, high power capacity, but at low frequency. Okay? From the point of view of power capacity, the heterojunction capacitor, heterojunction bipolar transistor has a medium power capacity. The CMOS has lower power capacity. The MOSFET has medium and the HEMT is medium power capacity. From the point of view of cost, bipolar junction transistor is the lowest price. It is very cheap transistor. On the other hand, the gallium arsenide, gallium arsenide high lithium mobility transistor is the highest price or the most expensive transistor. In between, the heterojunction bipolar transistor and the MOSFET are medium. Effectively, gallium nitride high lithium mobility transistor nowadays, this is high cost, this is not low cost. So it is not medium. So effectively, gallium nitride high lithium built transistor has slightly high cost. Because effectively, the fabrication and doping of gallium nitride is not simple process. From the point of view of power supply, bipolar junction transistor can use a single power supply. Heterojunction bipolar transistor can use single power supply. CMOS can use high single power supply. But for the MOSFET, for the HEMT, gallium arsenide or gallium nitride, we need two power supplies. One for the gate and one for the drain. Because the gate is negative and the drain is positive. So, effectively, from the point of view of biasing network, bipolar junction transistor and heterojunction transistor and CMOS a simple biasing network, but for MOSFET and HEMT transistors is quite complicated biasing. This is briefly a comparison between the different types of microwave transistors. In the following video, we are going to discuss in more detail the MOSFET and the HEMT transistors. Also, we are going to discuss briefly the MOSFET transistor. So, see you in the following video to see how the high lithium built transistor has such advantages and what is the main properties of high lithium built transistor. It is quite interesting. Okay, see you.